What up, YouTube? It's Doom NYC here with possible ban list leaks. Now, before you guys switch this video or whatever, I'm just showing you the possible leak that you guys already know about, already have seen. This stuff, Hunter, Foolish getting banned, and all this other good stuff. If Mizuki went to 2, I would just jump for joy. But anyway, this is the stuff that you guys have already seen, but now there's another leaked ban list that's just popped up very recent. So I want to be like one of the first people to post this up on YouTube. So if I just scroll up here, we go and we see possible March 2012 again. So this is the stuff right here. They don't have pictures, but they do have names. So here's the stuff that they're saying is forbidden. Mainspring Hunter. Obviously you guys know that's Wind Up Hunter. That makes the most sense in my opinion, because if you take away Hunter, then there's no more Wind Up Loop, and that makes the deck you know, less likely to do anything that's too broken. Now people playing Wind Ups actually have to play the deck, which to me is pretty awesome. I didn't expect Wind Up Hunter to be banned. I thought it may go to 1 if it did get hit. But again, you know, let's see what happens. This is just a possible leak. Next card we got, Jar of Avarice. This is obviously Pot of Avarice. This card being banned makes a lot of sense. This card is a game-changing card, just like Brain Control was. You know, if you're playing Plants or something, this can really, like, just change the game in your favor. So, I don't want this card to get banned. I really like Pot of Avarice, in fact. A lot of decks that I used to play double Avarice, and, you know, I can't play any of those decks now because Avarice at 1, and then Avarice at 0 would just be ridiculous. But, you know, Future Fusion getting banned, this is not too bad. A lot of people said that this has been gonna be banned, like, a few ban lists now. It would make sense if they did ban it because of, like, a lot of broken stuff. However, I honestly don't have a problem with Future Fusion being at 1. Being at 2 is kind of ridiculous. But getting banned is jumping the gun a little bit. You can't really anticipate something being overly broken until it happens, in my opinion. So, you know, you guys can talk about the Fusion stuff that's coming out in the future. But until that stuff wins a YCS and wins it by using Future Fusion, I don't think that we should ban this, you know, just yet. There's one more card here, but it's unknown, so we don't know what it is. Next, let's go to the limited stuff. We got Increasing G. For those of you who don't know what that is Max C. Honestly, limited, I can see why it would go to 1, but it's not going to 1. It's not even going to be touched, because it's a TCG exclusive. Until Japan gets that card, that card is not getting touched. So I definitely think that this is incorrect right here. I can't see Maxi getting hit, but, you know, if it does get hit, I'd be like, wow, that's ridiculous. Next up, we've got Pot of Greedosity. For those of you that don't know, this is Pot of Duality. Going to 1, I don't think so. Once again, I think that Pot of Duality is one of the most balanced draw cards that we've had in this game. And to be quite honest with you, if it went to 2, I would be okay with that, like what I suggested earlier. But going to 1, who would play it at 1? I mean, actually more people might play it because it's just 1. But at the same time, going to 1 would probably just crush it. I really don't see any reason for that. Next up, we've got Jar of Greed. This is by far the worst card on this list. Why would anyone want to hit this card? This card is just pure garbage. So, forget about that. We got Oppression of the Royal Palace. This, coming off the ban list, would make a lot of you guys very, very happy. Unfortunately, it's not coming off the ban list. This obviously can't be real, because why would they bring Oppression back this early in the XYZ era? It doesn't make any sense. Also, they just made that Royal Prison card, so people are probably going to be playing that since they don't have oppression. I don't think oppression's coming back, not yet anyway. Lagia going to one, this makes a lot of sense, in my opinion. Dino Rabbit, like I said in my ban list prediction video, was winning a lot in the OCG, and it's winning a lot in the TCG, so putting Lagia to one makes a lot of sense. Next up, we got Levier. Again, this is Empty Space Sea Dragon Levier. Well, Levier definitely should go to one. Levier may also be the first XYZ card to be banned, in my opinion. It could happen. Not this, obviously not this ban list, but in the future, it's a possibility. So I definitely see that this going to one is probably going to happen. And then there's one more unknown card for the limiteds that we don't know of. Now, we go to the semi-limiteds. They got Rescue Rabbit, which is not too bad. It'll slow down Dino Rabbit a little bit, which is something they need. But at the same time, it won't kill the deck. People still play the deck. So this is not too bad. Insecto Hornet going to two. I honestly think that this card should go to one, but maybe Konami would be trying something, seeing if putting it to two slows it down enough where people, wouldn't make the, it won't be as broken as it is right now. It's not too bad. Hyperion going to two. I disagree with this. I even disagree now thinking about it when I put it in my video. I think, honestly, if you want to hit agents, you put Earth to one and that's it. Someone's made a very, very good point about this to me. They said, you play three Hyperions, and there's only one way to summon Hyperion, which is, well, the main way to summon him is to remove an agent. Now, if you're playing three Earth and three Venus, you have six monsters to remove. If you only have one Earth and three Venus, now you only have four monsters to remove for three Hyperions. So I think if you put Earth to one, people stop running three Hyperions because they'll find them to be dead. So putting this to two doesn't make much sense. Just put Earth to one. Graffa going to two, I guess it would make sense, but honestly, Graffa should go to one. Playtesting Dark Worlds, I realize how good this card is, and it just can come on the field every single turn. That's pretty bad. I think Graffa should go to one, but if it goes to two, it's not too bad. Doesn't kill the deck that much. And then finally, Pure Flame Eruption. And for those of you who don't know what that is Rekindling. That card makes the most sense to go to two out of all these cards on this list. That's probably the best choice. Konami, if they put Rekindling to two, that'd probably be the best thing. One, Lavals are huge in Japan. I mean, people play Lavals like crazy. You guys really got to keep up with Shriek to find that out. But Lavals are all over the place. Rekindling at three is a staple in that deck, and the deck's winning a lot because it's able to pull off shooting Quasar Dragon pretty automatic. So, putting Rekindling to two would slow the deck down a little bit. To be quite honest with you, this deck has been broken for, I mean, this card, I should say, has been broken for a very, very long time. It just hasn't had the right monsters to be as consistent as it should be. But now with the Lavel stuff, things are only going to get worse. And Rekindling at two would not be such a bad thing because people would still abuse it at two. And eventually, in the next ban list, after the TCG exploits it, it's going to go to one, and then if it gets too ridiculous, it'll probably get banned. But Rekindling at two is, pretty obvious. So this is the stuff so far that, another leaked ban list. Again, I'm not too sure about it. A lot of the cards to me don't make sense. Some of them do. You guys will be the judge. Let me know what you think. Thumbs up the video for being one of the first people to put this up on YouTube. And until next time, YouTube, peace.